What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Well, 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 World Rugby are in the news and for something positive. World Rugby approves groundbreaking new play eligibility law. What does this mean? Well, the World Rugby Council has approved an amendment to the sports national team representation laws that will now permit an international player to transfer from one country to another. This decision comes after a meeting of the World Rugby Council on Tuesday when a vote was held on a proposal that would allow players to switch nations after a three-year stand-down period, provided that their parents or grandparents were born in the nation to which they intended to switch their allegiances. Under the previous law, once a player has played Test Rugby, they're locked to their country for life, unless they're able to utilise a loophole in Sevens Rugby. Both Malakai, Fekitoa and Lopeti, Timani, use Sevens to switch from New Zealand and Australia, respectively, to represent Tonga. However, World Rugby has now approved a new rule that will allow Test Rugby players to switch nations, subject to demonstrating a close, credible link to the union via birthright. The rule will come into effect the 1st of January in 2022 and will subject to the following criteria. The player must stand down from international rugby for 36 months. The player must either be born in a country to which they wish to transfer or have a grandparent or grandparent born in that country. Under the revised regulation 8 criteria, a player may only change union once. Each case will be subject to approval by World Rugby Regulations Committee to preserve integrity. The law will benefit a significant number of players, primarily from the Pacific Islands. Yes, please. Glad to see focus is going towards these guys who deserve it, who are playing a handful of tests for the likes of New Zealand, Australia and England, and are needed by their chosen nation and could represent a Tier 2 nation by the 2023 World Cup. How great does that sound? The development of the Pacific Islands have an opportunity now to really show what they're made of. It gives me goosebumps. I'm really happy about this. And it says the likes of Charles Piatau, Stephen Lotau, Nathan Hughes have all found themselves frozen out of Test Rugby at a young age and could use the law to represent a Pacific Island nation. Equally, former Wallabies fullback Israel Folau, who had his contract with Rugby Australia terminated after the incident that happened a few years back, could play for Tonga at the 2023 World Cup. What a difference that will make to Tonga. The proposal to change the rules around player eligibility is something that we have worked on for over many years. And our member association, International Rugby Players, CEO Omar Hussein, said, many players across the world will now benefit from the chance to represent the country of their or their ancestors' birth, serving as a real boost to the competitiveness of emerging nations, which in turn will benefit the game as a whole. I think this is great news. It's positive news. I'm excited. I'm motivated. And this is just what we need here for the Pacific Island teams, just to give them stronger, give them a little boost, give an opportunity to those who unfortunately can't play for New Zealand or Australia or England or whoever it may be around the world. It now gives them the opportunity to live by their birthright. Let's say for Macavena, Paolo and Billy, don't get chosen for England and still feel that they can play in the next 3 years, which I think they might be a little bit old. But what an opportunity to play for your birth country. I mean, it's amazing. And obviously vice versa for those guys, maybe have opportunities to go play in New Zealand or something. It can work that way too. So this is all positive news, and I'm really happy for the Pacific Island teams and all the guys who now get an opportunity, who had their contracts frozen, now can go shine and do stuff that they wanted to do, play for their dream country or their dream country of birth. For example, me going to play for Scotland because my dad is born in Scotland, or playing for for England, because my grandparents were born in England, or my grandfather in Ireland. It's an opportunity to spread your wings for those who unfortunately can't get selected. We've seen in so many instances why the players move from different countries. It's because either the coach or the school doesn't see the benefit in them or doesn't see the value in them. CJ Sutton is a good example. He was told he's too small to play for the Springboks. What is he going to do? He goes and makes history for Ireland. So this is a great opportunity for others out there to achieve their dreams, or others out there to be given a second chance into the industry to go play and prove their worth to the sport. So this is great news. Well done, World Rugby, for once. This is positive. This is positive for the South and around the world. So well done to them. I'm very happy about this. So let's hope positive things come from it. That's going to do it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Please hit that subscribe button. We are just under 15 away from 23,000. Thanks so much for watching. Stay safe and never give up. Cheers.